So let us go back to the Google Cloud Console, and I now want to create a database. So I search for cloud storage, not quite, that is Google Cloud Storage, the blob store. I look for SQL and create an instance, because and so I have various choices. There is MySQL and PostgreSQL and SQL Server. I'm very familiar with MySQL. I've used it quite often, so I think I will use this one. PostgreSQL arguably is even better, but I have not used it so far. I think it's quite similar. You can explore it for yourself. I really advise you to explore it. PostgreSQL is absolutely great. I will be choosing MySQL so far. Okay. So I need to enable the Compute Engine API first. Okay, fine. If they want, I will enable it. By the way, this will change in time. You know, these pages are never stable. So don't panic if you don't see exactly the same set of buttons. It didn't used that I have to enable this API. Now I do. Whatever, you know, you are sort of adapt and read the documentation otherwise. Okay, that took a bit of time. So now I can create my SQL instance. So I can give it a name. So because my app is called Luca Sample Project, I will call it Luca Sample Project DB1, because I'm really full of fantasy today. I need to generate a password here. What happens if I click on generate? Oh, okay, great. I get a password for the root user. And I copy this password again to a place where I can save it, so that I will then put it into my secrets file. Okay, one moment while I copy it down. Actually, it doesn't work to copy it down this way. Let me try one more time. Okay, that's not very smart of Google. I cannot copy that, so I have to stop the video, copy it, and then go on. Okay, goodness. Okay, I copied my password. The database version is 5.7. I don't know why. I guess the later version is also fine, but 5.7 has worked really well for me. We can put it in Iowa, I guess. Why should we? It's not clear to me. Do you have a preference for Oregon or Los Angeles? Let's put it in Oregon. Single zone or multiple zones, this depends on the availability. Let's leave it on multiple zones, why not? But I think we want to look at the advanced options, because essentially Google is like this salesman that say, oh, you need a car, yeah, here is a beautiful Ferrari, you know. This machine has 4 cores and 26 gigabytes of memory, which I bet is absolutely what you need when you are just starting out to develop and don't want to spend a lot of money, right? So this will be a money sink, like a Ferrari, I guess. Custom. So, goodness. Okay, you see, you have to click on shared core to be offered a cheap option, but please do. Okay, choose one virtual CPU, 0.6 gigabytes to start. If you need a bigger instance, you can always choose it later. This is essentially the compute instance that is connected to your database. If you need a bigger compute instance, you can just change the setting without having to recreate the database, which is stored in flash memory. So you can change this quite easily, and you should start with the cheapest you can. Public IP enabled, I'm not sure if it's needed, but it's good for debugging, and at any rate there is a firewall, I believe so. Let's leave it public IPs, because at any rate you have to authorize networks that can connect to the instance, so public IP is actually a safe setting. Backups, I can configure it, automatic backups, please leave it on so that you don't lose data. Having automated backups of your database is one of the great features. Maintenance, flags, labels, yada yada. Okay, I think I did it. So I think this is all. So I want to copy the instance ID as well, because it's one other of the data. I mean, it will given to me later as well. Instead of the password, I'm not quite sure whether I will ever see it again, so be sure to copy it. And now I can click on Create Instance, and the instance is being created. So we have already been able to collect the root password that we should store separately in some place. Now we have here the connection name. This is important. We can copy it and write it aside. And the connection name is what will go here, the DB connection. Okay, so this DB connection is the connection name that you can see here, and you need to copy it. Okay, so we have two elements already, and the other thing we need to have is the DB user and the DB name. So we need to create a database. There is no database for us yet. So I clicked on databases and I need to wait a little bit longer. Okay, the instance is still being configured, and so I cannot yet create a database. I just have to wait until this operation finishes. Okay, this took a while, so it finally finished, and now I can create a database for my application. This name is only unique within the project, so I can call it simply sample DB. Character set. The best choice is UTF-8 and B4. The catch here is that UTF-8 means that it uses Unicode with only 2 bytes per character at most. UTF-8 and B4 is the full Unicode alphabet, okay? So you need to choose UTF-8 and B4. Default collation create. Please note the name of the database somewhere. It's not a secret. You will be able to see it again if you don't, but still note it somewhere. SampleDB is the name, and the name will have to be put as the DB name here. Okay? So the last thing we need to do is create a DB user. You could also use the root user, but I actually prefer to create a DB user name specifically for this. And so let me do that. I go to users. I can create a user account, and I can call it like app user, because it's the username that will be used from App Engine. I can give it a password optionally, why not? Let me give it a password that I will then copy. Okay, done. And add. Good. Now, this is not really very secure because my app user has the same privileges as the root user, but I think it's fine for the moment because for any access from outside, you actually have to authorize outside access. So this will be okay for the moment. So now you should go to your settings file finally here and fill in your secret file, in your secret settings.py, the information on the database user, the database name, the database password, and the database connection. And the other thing you need to do is actually to import this information. So you have to say here from private secret settings, import everything. Okay, and so this will create the definitions. And so just when you think you are done, comes this obnoxious task. That is, you created a database, but the database is empty. It contains no database tables. And the Python Web expects the tables to be there, because if you look at how you created the database in common, migrate is going to be false. This CloudDB migrate is set to false. Okay. So you need to create the database tables yourself. And this is complicated, and to make it a little bit easier, I put in createTables.md in this help file essentially, the SQL code you need to do in order to create at least the three basic tables that the auth system needs. Then you can look at how these tables are created and you can figure out how to create additional tables. This will create the auth user table, the auth user tag groups table, and also the PyFerWeb session table that are needed by PyFerWeb. So this is a code that we use to create these tables. And the problem is how do we actually do it? We need to connect to the database to do this. And one easy way to do it is to use the Cloud Console to do that. So we can go here, we can go to connections, or maybe to overview. Actually, let's go to overview. And here we are given various options for connecting to this instance. And one of the easiest ones is to connect via the Cloud Shell. So we can click here, and this will create for us a connection to the database from a machine, essentially a Linux host hosted in the Google Cloud. It takes a moment. Okay, here we are already. Actually, it didn't take that long. I need to authorize it. And so, well, permission denied. Cloud SQL Admin API. Enabled it by visiting this URL and then retry. So I follow the instructions, I visit that URL. Hopefully it will work. Cloud SQL Admin API. Yeah, evidently I forgot to enable it. So let me enable that. Good. And now I can go retry. So I go back here. And I might simply need to retry the same command. So let me try that. Yes, it seems to work. So I will need my root password in order to be able to log in. This is essentially whitelisting the connection to the database from this shell machine that I have here. Okay, I'm here. I enter my password. And here I am. So I can give commands such as show databases. And this shows various databases. Some of them I didn't create. Information schema, MySQL, performance schema. These are used by MySQL management itself. But there is one sample DB. So I go use it. I say use sample DB. I'm there. I can say show tables. And this tells me there are no tables. Okay, good, but I can create my tables now. And so I created them one by one. I copy the definition of the auth user table and I'm gonna create it. And it worked. And if you want, you can say drop table auth user. This will completely delete the table. And you can recreate it. So if you make a mistake, you know, you can delete and recreate a table. Of course, you know, deleting a table will delete the whole table. It's not safe to do. It's only okay to do it now because the table is empty. So I can create my auth user tags table. Let's see. Okay. And the last table, PyFerWeb session, the all important table where the session will be stored. I take it and I create it. Good. Show tables. Very nice. Describe PyFerWeb session. This describes the table. It exists. It's fine. And you can also say show create table PyFerWeb session. So the difference is that describe gives you a nice description. Show create table tells you which commands you should use in order to recreate the table from scratch. Okay? So at this point, we have a Google project and we have a database active in Google project that is ready to be used from us. And so the last thing that is missing is that we need to learn how to upload our application, which so far sits in our personal development laptop, to the Google Cloud. That we do in the next video.